Good morning po sa inyong lahat. I pray na hanggang sa matapos po ang ating service, you will be with us. Amen? Amen. So, ngayon po, we are in our season 2, which is Jesus. Let's all read. God's life-changing word. Amen. And our anchor verse is coming from Romans 8:28-29. And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose. For those God foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. This is a very powerful scripture that reminded us that whatever is happening, ano man pinagdadaanan mo right now, believe that all things work together. If we keep our faith in God, we have that assurance na anumang pagdaanan natin, rest assured, lahat yun ay para sa ikabubuti natin. Amen po ba? So, I have a question. So, who among us here know the your family history? Yung family heritage mo, for example, ako sa aming barangay, known ang aking, my father is known as a barangay captain. And he's so very tough. So, in our barangay, they are expecting, since we are all 8 girls, they are expecting that, oh, this family will be like a barangay captain. Like, they are expecting one of us will be barangay captain soon. So, when my father, grandfather finished his term as a barangay captain, then my father, then after that my mother, then we said no, stop. So sometimes, you know, our family history, yung heritage natin, sometimes it defines us, right? Sometimes we are marked as, oh, this family is known as mata pobre, or this family is known as the most generous, they are giver. So if there is a solicitation, they will go here and there. So see, the importance of the family history, the family background, sometimes it really defines us. Amen? So our title for today's preaching is, Kanino ka nga ba? Kanino ka nga ba, Pastor Bench? Please translate. Amen. Our anchor verse is coming from John 8:34. Let's all read. Jesus replied, I tell you that everyone who sins is a slave to sin. Once again, I tell you the truth. Everyone who sins is a slave to sin. First, let's all pray. Hallelujah, Father. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, right now, Father God, we invite your holy presence. We invite your Holy Spirit to be in our midst, Father God. Lord, if there's anything, Panginoon, na nakikita mo that will hinder your presence to move, Lord, we cast it out in Jesus' name, Father God. Lord, and we declare victory, Panginoon, that you will do something greater in our lives today. And we will not go out in this place empty-handed, O God. Lord, let every words, Panginoon, that I will speak, Panginoon, Lord God, will only come from you, Lord God. Lord, ikaw po ang mag-glorify, not myself, O Lord. Hide me behind your cross, O God. Lord, thank you for your goodness, for your faithfulness. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. So, our scripture reading is coming from John 8:31-59. It talks about the dispute over whose children Jesus' opponents are. So we know that in the Gospel of John, while we started the series 2 and since even series 1, we spoke about the Jewish people and we saw the miracles of God, right? We saw the miracles of God, but not everyone believed that Jesus is really the Messiah. What do you think is the reason why? So, I will just share some of the background why the Jewish people don't believe that Jesus is really the Messiah. Jewish views on messianic prophecy in nature of the Messiah. In Jewish thought, the Messiah is expected to be a human leader, a teacher of God's law, descendant of King David, who will restore the Israel and rebuild the Temple of Jerusalem. So that is one of the criteria, expectation ng mga Jewish people. And then the other one is they are expecting that Messiah will gather all the Jewish people to the land of Israel. And as we go through our reading this today, we will see that they don't want to believe Jesus as the Messiah because they consider Jesus as a blasphemer. Right? They consider Jesus as a blasphemer. Why? Because Jesus is telling I am. It's like he is equating himself with God. And then lastly, Jesus challenged the religious teachings and traditions. So we saw that from from John 1 until John 7, Jesus started sharing the word of God, showing some miracles. And not all Jewish people believe in that, but there is one Jewish ruling council who believe him, and that is who? Nicodemus, yes. So let's read the verse, John 8:31 to 59. First, in John 31, to the Jews who had believed him, Jesus said, if you hold to my teaching, you are really my disciples. How can we be a true disciples of God? Paano nga ba? How? By obeying His commands, right? He said here, if you hold on to my teachings, you are really my disciples. And that obedience is instant obedience, not delayed obedience. Amen? So, I have shared here Matthew 16, 24 to 26. It says here, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it. But whoever loses their life for me will find it. What good will it be for someone to gain the whole world yet forfeit their soul? And also in Matthew chapter 10, 37 to 39, it says here, anyone who loves their father and their mother more than me is not worthy of me. Anyone who loves their son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up their cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds their life will lose it, and whoever loses their life for my sake will find it. Denying oneself, what do you mean by denying oneself, by the way? Is it like iuunahin mo yung gusto ng iba, like you will put the others first? In times of Roman romance, carrying your cross and crucifixion, isa ito sa common execution common execution sa mga condemned criminals. They will carry their cross sa street hanggang sa kung saan sila ipapako. So denying oneself involves surrendering our own desires and ambitions and align it with the will of God. Amen. Putting God first above our own preference, above our own choices. We have our own preference, amen? But, you know, when denying oneself means putting God first above anything else. Just like our song this morning, Jesus be the center of it all. By denying ourselves and carrying up our cross, we demonstrate our commitment to God. That, Lord, here I am. I am willing to follow you. I am willing to obey you. And you know, when having that new desire to follow him, it's not about like a one form, another form of being slave to Jesus. No, because when you really want to follow Jesus, you know, even it says here, even anyone who loves their mother and father more than me is not worthy of me. So God has given this example. Family, who else, who among us here don't love their family? Of course, we love our family, right? So God is not telling us to disobey our family, to disobey our father, but putting God first above our own preference, above our own family, because I believe if we put God first, sabi nga sa Romans 8:28, all things will work together for the good of those who love Him. Amen. And here, it says here, whoever loses their life for me will find it. Ano nga ba yung, what you will find? Is it just life? Oh, I'm alive. Buhay naman ako ah. So, what I will find? Life means like you will find the real meaning of life. A life that is with Jesus. A life that is full of satisfaction. Because we know, before we knew Jesus, hindi naman ganito tayo eh, when problem comes. We don't have that peace, right? But when we knew Jesus, we have given that privilege, you know, to be at peace when problem comes. He says here in verse 32, then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. What is the truth that Jesus is telling here? Remember sa chapter, John chapter 14, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So Jesus is pointing out here that there is a way. So if there's a way means there's a destination. And that destination is the Father. God, Jesus Christ, wants to bring us to that destination, to the Father. Hindi lamang pag we are dead. See, when we are not yet believers of Christ, when we don't know who Jesus is, we thought that when we are here, then that's the time we will just know Jesus. We will just see this, the second life. But no, Jesus is pointing out here that He wants, while you are still alive, while we are still breathing, He wants to bring us to the Father. Amen. Is it possible to bring us to the Father while still alive? Yes. Yes. He has a lot of promises. Amen. Here in John 33, they answered him, "We are Abraham's descendants and we have never been slaves of anyone. How can you say that we shall be set free? So here the Jewish people, their stance of their faith is that we are son of Abraham. Okay, so they thought that they are favored by God since they are descendants nga ni Abraham. But what God is trying to tell them is that the personal relationship is more important than having that, you know, the family traits. I've seen here that sometimes kasi before we were baptized as a Christian, my grandmother is the first one na believer sa buong family namin. So when I was young, I thought na pag isa lang sa family namin ang masave, that will be enough. I thought that once my mother or my father will be saved, automatic yon, hindi po pala. God is pointing out here that having that personal relationship to Jesus is more important. Amen? Jesus replied, "Very truly I tell you, everyone who sinned is a slave to sin. Now a slave has no permanent place in the family, but a son belongs to it forever. So if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed. I know that you are Abraham's descendants, yet you are looking away to kill me because you have no room for my word. I am telling you what I have seen in the Father's presence, and yet you are doing what you have heard from my Father." Being slave to sin means being unable to escape from the pattern of this world. you know, we are born sinners. We all know that. We already, one of our pastors shared about being born again. We all know that since birth, we are already sinners. But, you know, God is telling us right now that that sin is not about being slave, that na magiging kasambahay ka or physical sin. No. It's about the spiritual sin na nakagapos tayo. Jesus did not call us to be slave. He called us to be His son and daughters and to have a home with Him. Sin should have no room in our heart. Amen po ba? Do you agree with that? We have been set free not to do whatever we want, but to do what we are called to do. Ano ba sa palagay niyo kung bakit tayo tinawag ng Diyos? Bakit nga ba tayo pinalaya ng Diyos? That freedom that comes from Jesus means we have been given a new desire in our heart so that our obedience to God will not be a burden. Amen? Sometimes kasi when we say, okay, you are born again, you are now followers of Jesus, you are now, like here, you will belong to one ministry. Sometimes kasi nami-misinterpret natin yon. We thought that, oh, I need to follow these rules. No. You know, following Jesus, it's not a new form of slavery. Actually, it's a freedom because, see, you will have that benefit. I would really attest on that. Have you experienced following Jesus? Then, naramdaman nyo everything is okay? God did not promise that all will be storm-free. You will not feel any pressures. But God promised that whatever situation you are in right now, He will be with you. Amen? He said here, Abraham is our father, they answered. If you were Abraham's children, said Jesus, then you would do what Abraham did. As it is, you are looking for a way to kill me. A man who has told you the truth that I heard from God. Abraham did not do such thing. You are doing the works of your own father. We are not illegitimate children, they protested. The only father we have is God Himself. Jesus said to them, if God were your father, you would love me, for I have come from God. I have not come from my own. God sent me. Why is my language not clear to you? Because you are unable to hear what I said. You belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry your father's desire. He was a murderer from the beginning, not holding the truth, for there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks his native language. Ano nga po ba yung native language ng enemy? Lies, right? Deception. He is a liar and a father of lies. Yet because I tell the truth, you do not believe me. Can any of you prove me guilty of sin? If I am telling the truth, why don't you believe me? Whoever believes to God hears what God says. The reason you do not hear what the hear is that you do not belong to God. Jesus claims about himself. You know, we can see here that the Pharisees, masyado silang hooked sa law. They want to obey the law, but they forgot kung ano yung pinaka-heart ng law. They don't know what is the content, the main message of that law. They are trying to pursue the law, but they don't pursue Jesus. Amen? We sometimes, ganun din tayo eh. We know that Jesus is here. We are changed. We are saved. But sometimes, we are still doing things na alam naman natin na ikakasama natin, na alam natin na hindi gusto ng Diyos. Amen. Sometimes, ganun din po tayo, am I right? Ako lang po ba yung minsan nakakaramdam ng ganun? Sin, it's magnetic. Mahirap tumakas. Amen? It's very hard. It's very hard. Once na in-step mo yung feet mo, you thought, oh, okay, kaya ko to, kaya ko to. But no, be careful. Tanungin mo nga sa katabi mo, kanino ka ba talaga? For Jesus or full devil? Amen. These men, actually, they don't actually know God. And they don't want to know God. Sabi nga dito sa John 8:43, why is my language not clear to you? Because you are unable to hear what I say, sabi niya. They know the law, but they refuse to accept the truth. They don't want to listen. They don't want to, you know, to obey what Jesus said. Even there's a lot of marami na siyang proof that he is really. But the truth is something that the Pharisees cannot bear. So they are refusing it. Sometimes we also are like that. When we are being rebuked, masama ang loob natin. We only want to hear the words that, alam mo yung magaan sa pakiramdam natin, that suits us, that gives us comfort, but we reject the words, the commands of God that discomfort us. Sometimes we are the works of the enemy. He will sugarcoat the word. He will say, oh, it's okay. Ganito naman. You know, your mind will justify that. Okay lang, ganyan lang. Light lang naman yan eh. Ngayon lang naman eh. But you know, how to win over temptation? The word of God is so powerful. Amen. Sis Kayim and Sis Mercia. Can I ask both of you here? Sample lang. Amen. So, back to back lang kayo.
Back to back.
Ayan. Mas matangkat. It's okay. Bigyan mo naman ako ng space ng konti. Amen. Who among us here believe that 1 + 1 = 2? 1 + 1 = 2. Right. Amen. And 1 + 1 = 5. Wala, di ba? So, same with the Word of God. The Word of God is the absolute truth. It will not change in circumstances. It will not change kung, ako ngayon eh, very, very depressed ako. So, the Word of God, if He said it's like this, for example, this is the Word of God.
I don't think so, I will fit.
So, this is the Word of God. For example, the Word of God will not adjust for me to fit in. Amen. So, as a believer of God, I should adjust for me to fit in. But the Word of God will give me the grace, the love, the courage for me to fit in. So, that's how powerful the Word of God. Thank you, sisters. Thank you. That's how powerful the Word of God. Amen. Sabi dito sa James 1:12-18, blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, the person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised for those who love Him. When tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does He tempt anyone. But each person is tempted when they are dragged away by their own evil desires and entice. Then after desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And sin, when it is full grown, it gives birth to death. Don't be deceived, my dear brothers and sisters. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down to the Father of the heavenly light, who does not change like shifting shadows. He chooses to give us birth through the word of truth, that we might be kind of first fruit to all of all He created. So, we can see here that it's like the anatomy of sin. Saan nga ba nag-uumpisa ang sin? Sabi dito, each person is tempted when they are dragged away by their own evil desire. So in it, that is in John 1 verses 12 to 18. It speak about the sin, where it started. So as being a followers of Jesus, it's stated here, the desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin. It is full grown, it gives birth to death. So we need to be very careful kung ano yung mga nakalagay sa isip natin. Watch our thoughts, for they become your words. And your words, for they become your actions. And your watch your actions, for they become your habits. Watch your habits, for they become your character. So it's very important that we need to be very mindful of the things that is running out in our mind. Amen? We need to pay attention sa mga bagay kung saan natin nilalaan ang ating mga oras. Amen? We need to pay attention to our habits. We need to pay attention to what is our daily routine. Amen po ba? And we need to pay attention where we spend our time. We need to pay attention for something that pays us back with good things. Amen. Sabi dito, blessed is the one who persevere under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life and that the Lord has promised. So why, instead of doing something, instead of spending more time of something na hindi naman magbibigay sa atin ng benefits, why not pay attention to something that will pay us back? Amen? Tanungin mo nga yung katabi mo, most of the time, kasi minsan, di ba, sa cellphone, makikita natin how many hours we spend sa gadgets, sa Facebook, sa ganun. See, it matters. It matters. Why? Kasi pag ganun, nananakaw yung oras natin. It's an indirect attack of the enemy. Do you believe in that? And repentance is not just telling yourself, Lord, I'm so sorry. Lord, forgive me. No, repentance is something that you need to act on it. When we have sinned, kung tayo man ay nagkakasala, we need to act on it. Feeling sorry is not enough. Okay, feeling sorry. Okay, nahihiya ako. Okay, nakukonsensya ako. But, you know, the true meaning of repentance is doing something, and you know, you will put in your heart, you will desire that you will never do it again. Because sometimes kasi, oh, I'm sorry, Lord, nagawa ko na naman. Oh, I'm sorry, Lord. Oh, I'm sorry, Lord. No, the true repentance means you need to act on it. Feeling sorry, feeling shame, yung konsensya mo, it's not enough. It will not save you. You must do something about it. We need to be very intentional in obeying His command and decide if we really want to be free from sins. You know, just removing the feeling of guilty will not be enough. It won't work. Amen? Because, you know, I believe that Jesus came here on earth not to magnify the sin. Do you agree on that? Jesus came here on earth not to magnify the sin, because sin has no power over Him. Sin cannot do anything to Jesus. Sin has no power over Him. Jesus came here on earth to destroy sin and to magnify the goodness of God. Because the goodness of God leads men to repentance. You know, when while I'm reading this word, nasabi ko, Lord, I'm so sorry. The effort of God, you know, imagining your father standing in front of you. I just remember my mother when I was high school. Ma, I want to go with my friends. I want to go here and there. And my mom will say, no, you're not allowed. Then I will justify. Mommy, because like this, ano naman eh, kasama ko naman si ano. Ang sagot ng mama ko, nagpaalam ka pa, hindi ka naman pala susunod. So, you know, the heart of our father, sometimes, nakikita natin that yung mga rules na binibigay ni Jesus, sometimes pakiramdam natin, napakahigpit naman pala maging Kristiyano. No. If we really know Jesus, if we really know the heart of God, sabi nga, paulit-ulit kong sasabihin sa Romans 8:28, for God knew, for all things work together for the good of those who love Him. Amen. In verse 48, the Jews answered him, aren't we right in saying that you are a Samaritan and a demon possessed? I am not possessed by a demon, Jesus said, but I honor my Father and you dishonor me. I am not seeking glory for myself, but there is one who seeks it, and he is the judge. Very truly I tell you, whoever obeys my word will never see death. At this they exclaim, now we know that you are a demon possessed. Abraham died, and so did the prophets. Yet you say that whoever obeys your word will never taste death? Are you greater than our father Abraham? He died, and so did the prophets. Who do you think you are? You know, sa verse na to, sa reading na to, lalong na-upset yung mga Jewish people. Because sinabi ni Jesus Christ dito, very truly I tell you, whoever obeys my word will never see death. How come? Sabi siguro nagalit yung mga Pharisees. Sabi nila, you are really a demon possessed. Sabi nila dito sa verse 48, aren't we right in saying that you are a Samaritan and demon possessed? So inulit-ulit nila yon. So we are right. Tama nga kami, na demon possessed ka, ba't mo sinasabing ganyan? In the book of Revelation 20:11-15, it says here, then I saw a great white throne and him who was seated on it. The earth and the heavens fled from his presence, and there was no place for them. And I saw the dead, great and small, standing before the throne. And the books were open. Another book was open, which is the book of life. And in that book of life, the dead were judged according to what they had done, as recorded in the books. So, in this book, what is this type of book? This book is the book of life, wherein the dead people were judged according to what they had done, as recorded in the book. And those names who are not found in this book will be thrown into the lake of fire, which is described as the second death. But there is one promise that God the Father had given here. Very truly I tell you, whoever obeys my word will never see death. This passage shows that the importance of our faith, of our personal relationship with Jesus, na lahat ng bagay na ginagawa natin sa mundong ito, may consequences. Lahat ng choices natin, lahat ng wrong choices natin, meron at meron kalakip itong consequences. So instead of collecting bad stories to be recorded in that book of life, why not keep the stories of your victories, especially victories over temptation and sins. Amen. Is it possible? Amen. Just like David sa ating psalm this morning, nung nag-commit siya ng sin kay Bathsheba, when he decided to follow Jesus, as in talagang no turning back, I really love David. Sabi nga, 'di ba? He is the man after God's own heart. Because after committing the sin, after realizing that mali talaga yung ginawa niya, he never tried na bigyan ng chance ulit ang kaaway para magkasala. He remained faithful even sa mga trials na dumarating sa kanyang buhay. Hindi siya nag-twist ng faith. He remained faithful because he trusted. Nasubok ko na kung paano ang buhay na wala sa Diyos. Bakit ko pa gagawin? Amen po ba? I pray that the life of David, from becoming a sinner, you know, to becoming a man after God's own heart, you know, let's all desire to be like David. You know, his heart to follow Jesus in season and out of seasons, anumang bagay, like in our devotion sa aming praise and worship, we are studying Psalms. We read from verse 1, now in 18, like that, nakita namin kung ano yung heart of obedience ni David. Na hindi pala imposible. Posible din pala. Because we thought, naku, Diyos si ano, ganyan lang, kaya nagagawa niya. No. Even us, God will empower us. God will give us the ability to do what we are being called to do. Amen? 54, Jesus replied, "If I glorify myself, my glory means nothing. My Father, whom you claim as your God, is the one who glorifies me. Though you do not know him, I know him. If I said I did not, I would be a liar like you. But I do know him and obey his word. Your father Abraham rejoiced at the thought of seeing my day. He saw it and was glad. You are not yet 50 years old." And they said to him, "And you have seen Abraham?" "Very truly I tell you," Jesus answered, "before Abraham I was born, I am. Before Abraham was born, I am." At this, they pick up the stones to him, but Jesus hid himself, slipping away from the temple grounds. So, as I mentioned earlier, they considered Jesus as a blasphemer. And isa sa punishments ng mga blasphemer during that time is batuhin. You know, in this verses, it proves the introductory statement sa book according kay John, sa John 1 verses 1 to 5. John was relating what he heard Jesus said about John 8:58. He said here in John 1, 1 to 5, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." So it proves that at the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And who is that Word? It is Jesus, right? So they don't understand it because they are really blinded by the works of the enemy. They don't want to accept the truth because that truth is something they cannot bear. Amen? Jewish people, during this time, put their place and hope in Abraham's family. They don't realize that the hope of Abraham was found in God through the life of Jesus. It says here, "Your father Abraham rejoiced at the thought of seeing my day. He saw it and it was glad." Jesus is calling us to obey. Obedience to the highest level. Obedience means instant obedience, not a delayed obedience. Amen? In John 14:15, it says here, "If you love me, keep my commands." Obedience to Jesus is an expression of our love. As a believers, We need to demonstrate our faith, our commitment to Him, to glorify Him, which give Him glory. Amen? That means you don't have to practice your slavery to sin anymore. When the temptation comes, when the temptation is knocking on your head, oh, ganito ka dati, ganito ka. Ngayon lang naman. No, you don't have to obey that word again. Obey what Jesus said. You have been set free, and you do not have to listen to that voice anymore. Amen po ba? We are now sons and daughters of God. Amen? And this is not a new form of slavery because He did not call us to be saved. Jesus did not call us to be slave. Amen po ba? Do you agree on that? He called us to be saved. Amen. Be faithful to Jesus and never compromise. In Hebrews 4:13, nothing in all creation is hidden from God's sight. Everything is uncovered and laid bare before the eyes of Him to whom we must give account. Who among us here married? Amen. Marami po tayo. Who have best friend? Amen. So, napakaganda po sa pakiramdam na yung husband mo is so faithful to you. You have a best friend who is so faithful to you. How does it feel having a loyal husband, a faithful husband, a faithful wife, a faithful best friend? This verse highlights that the holiness and the righteousness of God do not compromise with sin. God sees everything. See, it's written here. Nothing in all creation is hidden from God. You cannot hide anything. Even yung nasa isip pa lamang natin, you cannot hide it. Iniisip mo na, ay, ganito si ganyan. Nasa isip pa lamang natin. Alam lang Diyos iyon. While God is loving and merciful, He is also just and cannot tolerate sin. So we need to be very mindful to pay attention to our works, to our actions. God's uncompromising stance about sin reminds us to turn away from sin, seek His repentance, and obey Him. Sin has no color. Amen po ba? Walang white lies, red lies, ganon. It has, wala din siyang kilo. Sin is a sin. You cannot change it. You cannot justify it. Amen? Next is exercise to think first before you act. Pause and pray. In Proverbs 14:16, it says here, "The wise fear the Lord and shun evil, but a fool is hot-headed and yet feels secure." This verse emphasizes the importance of thinking first before committing sins. You know, when you pause and pray, you will be having that privilege to filter kung ano yung man yung next step. Is it aligned with the God's will? You know, sabi dito, hot-headed, mainitin ang ulo. Yung so impulsive in taking decision. Exercise to think first before acting is to pause and reflect on whether our thoughts align with God's word and teaching. We can make a decision that honors Him by praying, right? God will give us what God will, the Holy Spirit will remind us of His teaching. We also have our pastors, we also have our leaders here who will counsel us. Who among us here experience na ma-counsel ng ating pastors? Ako lang ba? Ah, praise God. Amen. So, you know, going to your pastor, going to our leader doesn't mean that they will know my secret. They will know that I did like this. They will know. No, that's the lies of the enemy. And have you ever experienced that you're opening up to your pastor and you are so in pain and then they will tell you, for example, galit ka sa best friend mo or sa asawa mo, pastor, kasi ganito, and then sa haba ng sinabi mo, ang sasabihin sa'yo ng pastor mo, think about the good days. What? Napakahirap po naman yun, di ba? Maraming ginawa, tapos I will think about the good days. Parang napakahirap naman yun. Pero you know, I experienced it. Think about the good days. Pero you know, if you will really obey God's word, masakit, pero it will benefit you. You know, sin, when we are committing sin, just like what we said, before you commit sin, there are consequences. And if you are, for example, if you are married, not only you will be affected, not only you or your wife. Of you have your family, you have your mother-in-law, you know, the relationship. So, always think, before you act, we need to pause and pray. Sometimes when we are occupied, for example, we are overwhelmed sa pain na nararamdaman natin. Like, we just want to hear advices that will comfort us. Ayaw kong lapitan si Papi kasi sasabihin niyan sa akin ganito eh. Dito na lang ako kay Pas, ano, kasi alam ko maintindihan niya ako. Ang i-advise niya sa akin ganito, no. Amen? Sometimes it's really difficult. But that's what we have been called to do. Amen? And lastly, here. Yes to Jesus, no to sin. Start to live a holy life. Sin should have no place in our heart. Amen? In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 27, it says here, do not give the devil a foothold. In this verse, reminds us that sin should have no place in our heart. You know, sin can lead us to spiritual strongholds and separation to God. We are called to guard our heart, allowing only what is pure, lovely, and praiseworthy. Amen? By confessing our sin, we are seeking God's repentance. We can cleanse our heart and maintain a closer relationship with Him if we will just allow God to fill our hearts with His Word, with His Spirit, which empower us to resist the devil, resist the work of the enemy, and live in righteousness. We need to seek counsel. Amen. Kung may pinagdadaanan tayo, huwag natin itong sarilinin. Hindi ibig sabihin na lumalapit tayo sa ating leader means we are weak. No. Kasi the enemy cannot read our mind, but the enemy can put words sa ating isipan which will make us, you know, instead of doing this, he will, you know, push you to do something which really contradicts the will of God. Amen? So, our challenge, kanino ka nga ba talaga? Can you ask your seatmate, kanino ka ba talaga? Are you going to follow the voice of Jesus or the voice of the enemy? The voice of the enemy leads to worry. But the voice of God calms you. The voice of the enemy hurt you, but the voice of Jesus heals you. The voice of the enemy discourages you, but the voice of Jesus encourages you. The voice of the enemy steals your peace and joy, but the voice of Jesus gives you hope. The voice of the enemy breaks you, but the voice of Jesus makes you whole. The voice of the enemy will always confuse you, but the voice of Jesus will give you peace. He knows your name, but He calls you by your sin. But Jesus, He knows your sin, but He calls you by your name. The voice of the enemy will keep reminding us that we are a slave. But the voice of Jesus will remind us that we are saved. I would like to ask everyone to stand and let's pray. Father God, you know our heart, O God. And we cannot hide anything from you, O Lord. Lord, we thank you, Father God, for being so mindful of us. We know, Father God, we acknowledge, Lord God, that we are weak, O Lord. That sometimes, O Lord, may mga pagsubok, Panginoon, Lord God, na nasusubok ang aming faith sa iyo, Panginoon, Lord God. We fall into sin, Panginoon, Lord God. Lord, right now, Panginoon, as we come to your presence, O Lord, we are asking for forgiveness, Lord. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, there are consequences in our lives. There are consequences sa mga past decisions natin that manifest na nagiging, you know, like a challenges sa buhay natin ngayon. Jesus came here on earth not to magnify the sin that you have committed. Jesus came here on earth to say, enough is enough. Earth is not your home. God prepared a place for you. And in my Father's house, there's a plenty of rooms. And I want you to be in that place. The presence of your current situation doesn't mean the absence of God. Father God, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your faithfulness, O Lord. Dahil hindi mo kami sinukuan, Panginoon. You even gave your life for us. Minsan kang naipak, Panginoon. And once, Panginoon, na-experience mong mapunta sa grave, you have been in that place. So nothing in this world, Panginoon, na hindi mo kami kayang sasamahan, na hindi mo kami sasamahan, Panginoon. My brothers and sisters, I know na sometimes we fail to obey His words. Sometimes we fail to obey His commands. Sometimes, nangunguna sa isip natin yung pride, lies of the enemy, you know. But God is giving us this time to renew our faith in Him, to renew our love, and to say, Lord, help me. Help me to have that changed heart, Panginoon. A heart that is willing to follow you, Panginoon. A heart that is willing to obey your words. And I ask you, my brothers and sisters, to come here in front. You know, coming in the presence of God, ay hindi ito pagpapakita sa ating mga kabatiran that I am a sinner. No. Lord, we come to your presence right now with a humble heart. Lord, nothing else matters, Panginoon, kundi ang magkaroon ng personal relationship sa iyo, Panginoon. Lord, we are so sorry, Father God, sa mga nagawa namin, Panginoon. Kung kami man po, Panginoon, ay nadapa, Panginoon, nagkasala, Panginoon, sa iyong harapan. Lord, sa oras na ito, Panginoon, humihingi kami ng kapatawaran, Panginoon. Let your Holy Spirit move, Father. Yes, Jesus. We are so sorry, Father. Patawad, Panginoon. Patawad sa mga nagawa namin, Panginoon. Patawad, Panginoon, sa mga naisip namin, Panginoon.
Lord, even sa mga disobedience namin, Father God. Lord, forgive us, Father God. Maraming maraming salamat, Panginoon, sa iyong kaputihan, Panginoon, sa iyong walang humpay na pagmamahal, for your everlasting love, O God. For your love and your grace is greater than our sins, O God. Thank you, Jesus. And once again, Panginoon, we commit our lives to you, O God.
I commit again with all.